Buongiorno, Vario Stick here. Happy New Year to everybody. Buon anno, as they say in Italy. I hope you have a great one and a very prosperous one. But I thought we'd start this year off with a quick look at this. This is the MT SYNCHRONY Duo Helmet. I thought I'd do a quick review on the helmet for a couple of reasons. One, it's just turned up, so I've had it for about a week. And I've been out a few times on it, in it I should say. But also, when I was looking for a review on this particular product on YouTube, I couldn't find one anywhere. So I thought, well, I'll just use the power of a Vario stick. And we'll have a look at the helmet. It cost me just over £74 on sportsbikeshop.co.uk. You can find it at various different prices. There's also several different colours. I'll put little screenshots up of those. The price does vary considerably depending on the size of the helmet sometimes and the colour that you choose. But this particular one, as I say, was just around £75 from a sports bike shop. Well, why did you buy a helmet for £75, I hear you ask? Well, one advantage about living where I do is at this time of year, you can be still riding your bike. Although in winter in a lot of countries, well, you're going to lay your bike up for the winter. This part of the world it's quite conceivable that you could be riding your bike 52 weeks of the year. That's a little slot there for some visors. 52 weeks of the year, but of course the disadvantage with that is that you can be riding directly into the sun. So I thought, well, I'll buy a fairly reasonably priced helmet, but one that, as we can see from the back here, is fully spec'd up. It's got the ECE 2205, sorry, the ECE 2205 and the DOT certification. So it's fully certificated for the road, not obviously for the racetrack. But as I say, this time of year, you can be riding directly into bright sunshine. It's a bit like riding into somebody. We've got the full beam headlights on, so it's a bit of an issue. So I thought, well, I need a helmet with an internal sun visor, as we can see. Got one of those, very effective one actually, with an internal sun visor, but with a peak. I can duck down into the sun and shade my eyes so I can ride safely this time of year, rather than staring into bright sunshine and potentially losing sight of the road. So in consideration to the fact that I'll maybe only be using it a few weeks a year, I thought £75 for a fully certificated helmet actually isn't a bad price to pay. Also, if you're coming to biking on a budget, rather than buying a helmet of unknown origin, possibly off a bit of an odd online auction site, at least with a helmet like this, you're getting a proper certificated helmet from a recognised manufacturer, and you're buying them from a proper sales organisation. So for £70 odd, you can have a safe helmet and one that is properly certificated and safe to use. That's the MT helmet. This peak here is a kind of an off-road addition, but I think it's a great idea, and it's nice and stiff. I was a little bit worried that we start getting up to 60, 70 mile an hour and this thing's going to start vibrating, oscillating in the wind, and it certainly doesn't do that. I had it up to about 70 the other day and it was absolutely fine. It is a little bit noisy, I have to say, but for the price I've paid, I'm more than happy with that. The visor itself can be, as you say, one, two, three, there's two on the other side, can actually be removed, so you can have your normal helmet for maybe your commute to work, and if you go out doing a bit of off-roading, you can put your peak back on for the weekend. As I say, I've only bought it for the middle of winter, so I'll only be using it a few weeks a year. The peak will stay on, and then for the rest of the summer I'll be using my other helmets. It's got the anti-breath visor on, as I call them. This is the ventilation here, That's the only kind of ventilation in, but there are a few, as we can see from the back here. One, two, and a couple at the bottom. Exhaust vents at the back. I'll go through the things I like and dislike in a minute. Also, the internal bit of the helmet is washable. You can take all this, all comes out. So you want to put your comms in there, or you want to wash it when it starts getting a bit smelly, these helmets always do, then you can. On this side, I think I've already mentioned, that's quite easy to get to, I think. A lot of people say it's quite difficult actually, but with your gloves on, I think you can catch that quite simply. It's just turned up, so I've been out a couple of times on it. So this is kind of your initial first review of the helmet, see what I think. I'll probably come back in another 6 months. Hopefully by then they'll have had a full winter using the helmet, when the sun is out, as it is today, and have a better idea of the full pros and cons. But I've got a list here of things that I have noticed thus far. The weather I've been riding it in has been sunny, quite dry, cool or cold, so it's kind of an average normal winter weather really, but without the rain. Nothing particularly serious on the cons side, to be absolutely honest with you. It does tend to fog up when you're moving slowly or when you're stopped at the lights. If you're going to buy this as a commuter to work, you might want to take that into consideration. There is no pin lock available with the visor. So I know there's lots of chemicals and washing up liquid and all kinds of stuff you can squirt on the visor to help stop it misting up. But I noticed when I was riding slowly or stopped at a junction, it did tend to mist up. Not particularly fog up, but you just got that mist on the inside. You can, might be able to demonstrate that, just click that open, just one little tiny bit like that, and it immediately opens up and the misting goes away. And if you're moving very slowly through town, stop, start, roundabout, junctions, etc., that might be enough just to keep it clear. But once you're moving, once you get 30, 40, 50 miles an hour, then that fogging clears up as the air gets through the helmet. It is a little bit noisy, not prohibitively so. I've got some more helmets that are a lot more expensive than this and they are a lot quieter. You know, £74.99, you're not going to get the wind-tested helmets that you get off Schubert, etc., etc. It is a little bit noisy, not prohibitively so. I've been out in 2 or 3 hours in it without earplugs on, in I should say, and it's not the end of the world, but with earplugs it'd be absolutely fine. It's got the click fasteners on it, not the D-locks. Now, I do prefer the double Ds. This particular helmet, as you show here, has got this click fastener on it. I know a lot of people don't like them. It's metal, it's proper piece of gear. It's not flimsy and horrible and nasty. That goes in there. And it's very easy to find, even with your gloves on. You just pull your tab and that's out. So with that tongue on it, it's easy to find that with your gloves on, and it's easy to take it off again. So whilst I prefer the double D's, this is, and it's adjustable as well, this is adequate, and as I say, it does perform up to DOT and the ECE ratings. There's another bit of padding there. This padding's nice and firm at the minute. It's going to loosen off. It says on the website it's only available in one shell size. Now, I am a 61 to 62 centimeter XL. This fits me like a glove. I know what a really good fit is, as most people do who've had many different helmets, and this is a really good fit. For me, the shape of my head is an XL size. It's absolutely brilliant. It's a bit tight at the minute, a bit hamster cheeks. I know that, but I know all this will ease off in time, and this is going to be a really, really nice fit. Give it another few outings. It'll be absolutely spot on. One other little observation, it's a bit heavy. You're going to expect it to be a little bit heavier, of course, because it's got a peak on it. But again, that's nothing... I don't think that's going to stop me buying another one, put it that way. So just to sum up the kind of cons with the helmet, it does fog up when you're not moving and there's no pin lock available. It's got the click fastener, or the ratchet fastener. I prefer the double Ds, that's me. It's a little bit noisy, that's probably something to do with the peak as well, and it's a little bit heavy. But there's nothing there that, as I say, would stop me buying one, or if somebody asked me, I'd say, yeah, go and get one. These are, for £74.99, including free UK delivery and 12 months return. I don't think that's a bad helmet, especially if, like me, you're only going to use it for a few weeks of the year, or if you've only got a little bit of money to spend. Going on to the good points, the things I like about this helmet, well, obviously the price is one thing, £74.99 including delivery, I don't think is a bad price for a fully certificated brand new helmet. I think that's great. It's fantastic. It's really comfortable. It's a little bit tight at the minute, but I know that's going to ease off. And I think as an XL, this is going to fit me like a glove. The field of vision. Now, I know that there are rules if you want your certification so far as the vision top to bottom and the vision side to side is concerned on helmets. But this, when I first put it on, I did notice, and as I say, I've got other helmets that cost me a lot more money than this, but I did notice, sorry, the fingerprints, I did notice the field of vision was absolutely spot on. You can see right around the corner here, so if you're doing your shoulder checks before you're pulling out or changing lanes, you know, when you're turning, you can see right out the side of the helmet. It's fantastic. Great top to bottom vision as well. So the vision out the visor, out the helmet, is as good as any helmet I've ever had on with a visor. It's really, really good. The sun visor is great as well. I'll try and demonstrate that again. That just drops down here. It's, I don't know if you can see, but it comes almost down to the bottom. I'll try and drop the camera down a little bit further. It's almost down to the bottom here. So in the summer, you could almost wear this with the visor open. It's a really good sun visor, and optically, I think it's quite clear as well. Some of those you get a little bit of rippling in them, but this one, this particular one, seems fine to me. I think it's easy to get at. I have read a few reviews that say it's difficult to get at, but I think with your gloves on, you can easily get that, and it's a nice positive action going up and down. So the sun visor's very good. As I think I've already mentioned, the peak, that's all removable. You've got the screws at the top, two on either side, so you can do your bit of off-roading at the weekend and then turn it back into a normal helmet when you're commuting to work. There's no real buffeting from side to side. I was a little bit worried about that because some helmets with peaks on do tend to catch the wind and you start to get this oscillation, which is particularly uncomfortable. But I don't know whether it's because it has vents here at the back or it's not particularly wide at the front. I don't know what it is, but it doesn't vibrate, it doesn't oscillate. We were up to about 70 mile an hour and it was absolutely spot on. Also, I think it's a good looking helmet. I think they've got it right here. As I said, they've got it in various different colours. I've already shown you those, but the black one I think looks particularly smart. So that's the first review. As I said, I'll come back in a few weeks' time of the MT helmets. A Synchrony Duo. This particular one is your matte black. There's some more vents at the back. Two vents here. It doesn't come with any sophisticated bag. It's just one of these, you know, kind of bags that you put it in with the drawstrings on it. I can find them. There we go. But we're talking about a helmet here for £74. You know, not a £700 or £800 helmet. More vents. That's the up and down lever for the sun visors. Nice big solid front visor, like I've already mentioned. Great field of vision, really, really spot on. Shoulder checks, dead simple with this. More vents at the top there, and a good solid peak. That's your only air intake, but it's there, and again, easy to find with your gloves. So that's the helmet. As I say, I'll come back in a few weeks' time and do part two. When I've had a chance to wear it properly, maybe in the rain, and maybe on a more of a humid or cold day. The days I've been out have been fairly sunny, fairly cold. Typical December days, really. So, hope you enjoyed that. If you did, please like and subscribe. We don't just do motorcycle gear on the channel. We do trips around different parts of village and tours around Abruzzo. We do a little bit of cooking. We do a few features down the old farmstead and, of course, the dogs and various other things. It's an expat life and the kind of things I get up to whilst I'm out here. So please join us, like and subscribe, and don't forget we've also got a Facebook page at Vario Stick. So from my new MT helmet, Synchrony Duo, matte black, this is Vario Stick saying Happy New Year and ciao ciao for now.